Now, the first official evidence of Israel possessing nuclear weapons may have been discovered by a U.S. academic. Britain's Guardian newspaper has published the declassified agreement, which suggests Israel offered to sell arms to South Africa in the 1970s. RT's Paula Sleer has more.
It's always been well known that Israel had a relationship with apartheid South Africa, but the extent, the scope, the nature of that relationship has always been shrouded in mystery. What we're hearing now from the British newspaper The Guardian is that back in the 1970s, there was a series of high-level secret meetings between the then Israeli Defense Minister Shimon Peres, who is today Israel's president, and the then South African Defense Minister P.W. Botha. And according to the minutes of these meetings, South Africa asked Israel for nuclear warheads, and Israel responded by offering three different kinds. Now, these documents have come to light by an American author who was researching a book on the close relationship between Israel and apartheid South Africa. And according to that author, the current Israeli authorities put a lot of pressure on the post-apartheid South African government not to declassify these documents. As you can well imagine, the reaction from Israeli authorities has been one of denial. We've heard from a spokesperson from President Shimon Peres' residence, and he said, and I'm quoting, "We regret that the newspaper did not find it right to ask for an official response and examine the facts with official Israeli sources. Other Israeli sources have called this a complete fabrication, completely denying this report." Having said that, though, if this report does prove to be true, it will be the first official evidence that there has been that Israel has nuclear weapons. As you well know, Israel's policy until now has been one of neither denying nor confirming that it has a nuclear arsenal. They have constantly followed a policy of ambiguity. If this also proves true, Israel will find it hard-pressed to prove its argument that even if it has nuclear weapons, it is a responsible country, as opposed to Iran and the whole question around a possible nuclear ban. Israel has constantly maintained that Iran is a threat and cannot be trusted by the international community. What is also interesting is that all of this is coming to light in line with Mordechai Vanunu, who is the nuclear whistleblower here in Israel, being sent back to prison for 3 months. Vanunu was arrested back in December when he violated the terms of his parole by meeting with a foreigner. Vanunu was arrested back in 1986 and spent 18 years in prison for revealing the inner workings of Israel's nuclear plant in Dimona to the British Sunday Times newspaper. Vanunu was offered a 3-month jail sentence or a 3-month community service, and he's been sent to prison because he insisted on serving that community service in Arab East Jerusalem, and the Israeli authorities saying that that could not be accepted. There's certainly a lot of questions being asked in Israel today. If these documents prove true, it sheds light on what is going on behind the scenes and the whole question of whether or not Israel really does have nuclear weapons.